Welcome to the Awesome Kids Ministry.
Hi kids, this is Teacher Abby and I welcome you to the Feast PICCAM Awesome Kids Ministry online session for today. Are you all excited? Before we begin, let us recall God's big message for you last Sunday. Can I hear you say it? That's correct! You may still view our past episodes through our social media platforms. Let us now welcome the Awesome Kids First Timers with one awesome clap. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Awesome! We hope you do join us every week, kids. Let us now begin our session with our opening prayer and the time for worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Today, I receive all of God's love for me. Today, I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today, I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today, I open myself to God's Word so I would become more like Jesus every day. Today, I proclaim that I'm God's beloved, I'm God's servant, I am God's powerful champion, and I am God's awesome kid. And because I am blessed, I am blessing the world. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Awesome kids, let's get ready to worship!
Whatever is pure, whatever is right, lead me in. trust, what comes to your mind? What does it mean to you? Is it something easy, something easily given, something earnestly earned, or is it so hard to do? Let me tell you a secret. Trust is easy if you L-O-V-E, love. Good day, awesome kids, and welcome to the last talk for our series. I am your teacher, Jenny, telling you that no matter where you are, no matter what you are going through, no matter who you're going to be, rely on the Savior and trust God is in charge. Now back to the secret. We all know that God is love, right? And wherever love is, God is also there. Sometimes the task and obstacles ahead may seem too hard. But if you know and believe in your heart that God loves you, you will trust that He will get you through it. He is your Father, the one who will never judge you, will never leave you, and will always love and bless you. And because today is a special day for God the Father, may I invite all of you to say a little prayer. Father, we know you are always there, and we know you will never leave us. And thank you for loving us and trusting us always. We love you and happy Father's Day, Papa God. Amen. And now, turn to your father or the man you consider as your father and greet them a happy Father's Day as well and give them that hug and kiss they so deserve. Trust and love go together. If you believe that God loves you, you will always do your best to achieve what you want to become while at the same time bring His love to others. Know in your heart that whatever the outcome, God will always be there and He will always remain in love with you, His children. In doubt, talk to God. Listen to what He is telling you. In pain, listen to His message for you. And allow Him to comfort you. What is He teaching you out of this difficult situation? Happy? Spread that to others who need a light of hope. No matter what you are going through, praise God for trusting and believing in you. Life will be full of ups and downs, but the God who loves you will always be there with you and for you. He is always holding your hand. Be that source of happiness, hope, and trust for others as well. That is your mission. Awaken the Spirit in you. How do you make this happen? 3 B's. First, be a bringer of hope. In the story of Peter, he was able to perform so many miracles in the name of God. But the greatest miracle with Peter is him turning from an unbeliever to someone who loves and trusts God as he changes the nation with the Holy Spirit in him and the love of God spreading through the world through him. It doesn't matter if you have a fast or if you still fail from time to time. What matters is you continue to improve and become a better Christian every day. In the past, it was Peter and the saints. Today, it could be you. Yes, you! How are you bringing hope? You don't have to be performing miracles. It can come from a simple hug and kiss to your tired parents or family members. It can be by helping your siblings with tasks and homework. It can be by praying for others. As long as it is from the heart, the love of God will bring hope to others through you. Second, be a bridge builder. Becoming the middle person for others is not easy. Sometimes you will feel like you're between two hard stones. But with the courage God gives us through the Holy Spirit and Jesus when we repent from our sins, we will be able to help others have peace and love for each other. It will never be easy. it will always be worth the try. Instead of adding conflict between your loved ones and friends by taking sides, be the bridge that allows them to heal and forgive each other. Instead of being a bully in school, be an influence of peace and joy to your classmates and teachers. Be Jesus to others. Support and love everyone regardless of your own beliefs. Pray for them and allow God to heal those who are hurt. Remember that as long as God is with you, miracles can happen. Last but most importantly, be a model of love. It's not easy to love if you are only loving from your own ability. If God is in your heart, loving is very easy. Being kind is very easy. Doing good is very easy. Trusting is very easy because God is love. Jesus died for us to show us how much He and the Father love us. You don't have to die the way Jesus did. You can do the little things like putting the preferences and desires of others over yours. Having the courage to say, I'm sorry when you did something wrong. Be the love that God wants this world to accept and become. Because we are all His children. And because we are, we too are loved. I pray that God's love will always shine through you, awesome kids. Remember, it will not always be easy. But trust that God is in charge. I hope you learned a lot from our lesson today, kids. We love and miss you, and we hope to see you soon. And now, let's get ready for your activity. Have fun, enjoy, be blessed, and be loved. Bye!
Hello there, awesome kids! It's me, your teacher, Mike. I'm happy and excited to join you for our activity today. But before that, let us greet our daddies, tatas, and papas a happy Father's Day. Our big message for today's talk is trust that God is in charge, and He is calling us to go outside of our comfort zone and share the good news of His love to others. Today, we are going to make a steering wheel as a reminder that we should let God to steer our lives. To start our activity, you need to prepare the following art materials. Please don't forget to ask for the guidance and help of your parents or guardian. Let's start!
Draw a circle in the center of your paper plate, or you may trace the line that you can see on the plate and cut it out. On a piece of paper, cut a strip. You can also use colored paper to add colors designed to your craft. Paste or glue both sides of the strip at the back of your paper plate. In the middle, write our big message, trust that God is in control. You can also write the 3 B's that we learned earlier to remind us to trust Him and spread His everlasting love for us to others.
And we're done! I hope that this art craft will always remind you that God is always in charge no matter what happens and whatever situation we are in. Please share a photo of your work on our FB page, Feast PICCAM Awesome Kids Ministry. Thank you, Awesome Kids! I hope you had fun today. God bless you! See you next Sunday! Bye! Let's get ready to thank God by putting ourselves in His holy presence. In the name of the Father, of the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. Thank you, Lord, for our work and play. Thank you, Lord, for all the things that we have learned today. Send forth all the saints and guardian angels to guide us on our way. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Bye!
See you next Sunday!
See you next Sunday!
Stay safe!
God bless you!
I can see you!